In this video, we show how you can debug your client-side JavaScript code in Grid and UX components. So you can see that we have a really trivial UX component here with a button. And in this button, we have some JavaScript code here. And then at the beginning of the JavaScript code, we basically have the keyword debugger, which is going to cause the script to pause and allow us to debug through the code. But the key thing to remember is that the script will actually only pause if the debugger has actually been opened. So let's go ahead now and we'll go to working preview. And because we want to use the Chrome debugger, we need to make sure that we have set working preview, and this could also be in live preview, that we have set working preview to use Chrome. So working preview can either use Chrome or Internet Explorer. So if you see Internet Explorer here, you should switch to using Chrome. So now you can see if I press this button now, I'm going to go ahead and open the debugger. And so now the debugger has been opened in another window. And then I'm going to go ahead and press this button. So you'll see now that we are paused in the debugger. And if I give focus to the debugger, I can see basically where in the JavaScript code we're currently paused. So you can see we're inside this button here, and we're about to execute this line x equals 1. So one of the really nice features of the Chrome debugger is the ability to put watch variables in the console window. So you can see here I've got the console window opened underneath my source, and I'm going to go into this console. Basically, let's just clear what's out there and click on this little create live expression and create an expression to watch the value in this variable called x. So currently x is undefined, and so now what I'm going to do is step over the next line. So I'll basically tap on this line, so you can see now basically as we step over this line, the value of x is now equal to 1, and then if I step over the next line, the value of x is now equal to 2. So I can step over all of the code in my JavaScript functions and scripts, and I can also watch the value of variables in the console window, which is in many ways more convenient than having to go to the watch panel over here and add my watch variables here, because this watch window contains a lot of additional variables whose values I might not care about. Thanks very much for watching.